हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम निशा शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश एंड द टॉपिक अंडर डिस्कशन टुडे इज अ क्रिटिकल एप्रिसिएशन ऑफ हिरोशिमा बाय अग्गे। एंड एज यू नो द अग्गे इज द पेन नेम ऑफ सच्चिदानंद हीरानंद वात्स्यायन एंड दिस पोएम वॉज रिटन बाय अग्गे इन हिंदी and it was translated into English by Leonard Nathan and Agge himself. Agge is the pseudonym of Sachidanand Hiranand Vatsyayan, major Hindi poet, novelist, critic and journalist. He is a modern poet. In his poetry, we find the thoughts and the points of reflection which affect the life of a contemporary man. Being a poet, he faces the questions which affect his writing. These questions are related with the social, political, psychological, and economic conditions of his time, as can be seen in his poem, Hiroshima. The themes of his writings are men and society, culture and cultural awareness, science and human values, liberty, a responsibility, etc. Hiroshima is a modern poem. It deals with the humanistic and socialistic leanings of the poet towards the immeasurable plight of the innocent people of Hiroshima, a city of Japan, where the atom bomb was dropped by America. It also shows the brutality of human being, the unwanted violence caused by the haughty and self-centered politicians, the horrible and incredible human brutality and butchery against humanity. In technique and style, the poem has modern tone and temper, full of hard and solid images, which remind us of T.S. Eliot, Ezra Pound, Hopkins, and Auden, and other war poets. In order to understand the poem, one should go to the background of the history related to the bombardment of America on the two important cities of Japan, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, during the Second World War. These two cities have become today memorable because of the naked dance of death of human beings towards human beings or the indiscriminate use of arms and ammunition. We know that during the Second World War, America wants to get a very early conquest and its dominance over Japan. So it dropped atom bombs without knowing anything about its consequence on the two great cities of Japan. As a result, many people consigned to ashes, their dwellings demolished, their dreams and aspirations shattered to nothingness, and the whole activity of the city reduced to the dust. This traumatic experience has been haunting not only to the people of these two cities, but also the whole world. Based on this theme, the poem is very interesting in matter and manner, feeling and form. And now a brief summary of the poem. The poet is comparing the sun with a bomb. The sun that is rising, tearing the horizon, is greeting people. And the poet uses this description to compare with the bomb that tore open the earth and bit people with the darkness of death. The bomb that was thrown by the USA hit the center of the city and blasted with enormous clouds of smoke, making a dreadful scenario in the city, as if the city lied up on the heap of death. When the sun is over our head in the sky, there is a shadow of our body created by the light of the sun. But here the human shadows are dazed and lost. In other words, there were no men, so there were no shadows. The phrase death swart sankar is also very connotative. It connotes how the atomic blast is just like the wheels of the sun, causing violent death all over. Through the entire poem, the poet is expressing that men themselves destroyed their self. Men were themselves destroyed by their self-creation. The terrible blast of the bomb flashed out very suddenly and also subsided in a moment. So both the rising and the setting of the sun were done within a very short period of time. We know that the sun generally rises in the morning and sets in the evening. But here in this city of Hiroshima, this whole process of the sun from morning to evening were confined to few seconds at noon of the day. This is why the poet uses the phrase one compressed noon. This phrase also shows the cruel and inhuman activity of human being to change the rule of nature. This poetic and metaphoric description present a very realistic picture of that situation caused by the atom bombs. The poet is of the opinion that all men of the city were dying as suddenly as the mist. In the natural process of the day, the heat of the sun dries the mist on the blades of the grass. But here, this man-made fierce and horrible bomb end the life of men within a very few minutes. The only thing that stays in the city is the shadow. Again, here the term shadow has got a number of meanings. At first, it suggests the dark aspects of the satiric behavior of men. It also denotes the stain and scar made by the merciless mankind towards the innocent mankind. These dark shadows have haunted the civilization and is still haunting and will be haunted in the next generation. So the only thing that stayed today is the shadows. On the second scale of meaning, the shadow here also denotes the shadow caused by the flame of the burning rock and stones of the vacant streets, as there were no people in the city. The advent of technology and science will become the threat to human civilization due to its misuse. It would hardly bring positive changes if human use science for power, and soon it will erase the existence of the human being from the globe. According to Paul, Hiroshima would always tell the narrative what the abuse of power resulted in. Again, except the fact that we are living in a modern world which does not have the medieval lifestyle. Science has taken the prime importance. There is no doubt that scientific inventions have changed our atmosphere. These inventions have brought about fundamental changes in our beliefs. The problem is that we are not able to accept this fast change in our lives. Although this mechanical progress makes the work easier, but it does not give inspiration to our soul. The atmosphere of this mechanical progress has presented such a crisis before man, which was not there earlier. What Agay wants is that this relation of man and machine should end the trouble of differences of human beings and helps him in his hour of need. This would be the beneficiary or constructive side of scientific inventions. But today, the love of power and greed inspires the powerful ones to use these inventions for destructive purposes. Destructive war is a problem of contemporary period. We find ourselves surrounded from all sides with destructive war conditions. These conditions are not confined to a particular nation in this globalized world. The seed of enmity for each other has been sown all over the earth. People have lost their cheer and joy for life and feel suffocated. The experimentalist mentality of Agay recognizes this irony and feels that this inhumanity is still a change before us to overcome. Being a modern poet, Agay was well aware of the national and international situations. He knew it very well how these superpowers are engaging the whole world into violent competitions for their petty gains. He knew the fact that this inherent aggressive attitude is affecting the whole world. This fact was also referred by great people like Einstein and Freud. The threat of war feared by Einstein and Freud in 1932 was seen in reality in the form of Second World War, in which there was much use of atom bomb, or to say of the destructive power of science. In the poems of Agay, if war has been presented as a problem, the reason is that war is the result of violent nature of man. And this violent nature of man is making immoral use of machines and science. Just as in the medieval age, orthodox views acted obstructively and destructively in the development of human beings, in the same way, today, science is being used for destructive purposes. Atomic power can be used for the happiness of humanity, but the same atomic power is becoming fatal. The Second World War proves it. Bomb explosion on Hiroshima is undoubtedly an immoral use of science, which proves how immoral the society has become. Art is universal. It is not confined by time or place. A gaze views are relevant even today. The situation which was presented by Agge in Hiroshima has not improved yet. It is getting worse. These explosions are becoming a routine matter nowadays. The only difference that can be seen is in the reaction of people towards them. Not a single day passes when we don't come across such happenings in different parts of the world. The point makes up a comparison between the life-giving power of nature and destructive power of man. The son of nature gives life to vegetation, man, etc. But the sun, the atomic bomb created by man, causes destruction. This man-made sun has destroyed its own creator. Thank you. We haven't dealt in detail the text of the poem because we have already done it in a separate video. So now, thank you.